Welcome to Code with Steven. Today is the final day that we all have been waiting for, the advertised day. I told you that at the beginning of this class, at the end of the day, I'm going to build a website from the scratch using just HTML and CSS. Mail after learning HTML and CSS. Now that we are through with everything about HTML and CSS, let us now go ahead and build our website. So for us to do that, you have to create a folder. Let's start from the scratch. And let me also tell you that I want to use a very simple language, simple way that everybody can easily understand and practice. So I create a folder and I name it Steven. So the next thing for us to go to our VS Code. So click on your, open your VS Code. And from VS Code, you go to File, go to File, Profile, you go to Select Folder. Go to File, Profile, go to Select Folder. Open folder, then from open folder, let's check our desktop, and I have my Steven folder, so I'm going to choose the Steven folder, open the select folder. You want to save changes? No. So it's going to open for us. Now that has opened, the first thing to do is to create a file as usual. So I'll create my first file, and the first file should be index.html. index.html, okay, and from that you create another file.
Let's go ahead with another file.
Name this file style.css. Let's go ahead and create another file. index.html style.css. Let's create another file. Name this file image.jpg. image.jpg. Okay, this is a three file that we don't work with for now. Later we'll go on and create other files, but for now make sure that these three files you've created it. So let's go ahead, come back to your index.html and bring out your HTML skeleton. Bring out your HTML skeleton, HTML 5. You might not need all of these, but we need the title, so put your title. I will name the file title web design. Name it web design. Okay. I'm going to start to name it Steven, but you name yours anyone you like. Then link it with your link your HTML with your CSS. So it will be style.css. Then let's go to the body. And this body, we want to create some div, okay, some classes. Okay, so first of all, let's create a class with a div. We will create a div with a class named main, okay? So it should be div main. Bring it down. Then in between, let's create another div. Let's create another div with a class. And my class should be navbar, okay? Just nav. Let's not writing too much. Nav. Bring it down. And in between, let's create another div with a class. This time around, the class should be, they talk about navbar. Let's use icon. Okay, let's use icon. I thought you did. Okay. Let's use icon. Then in between, we create another class. But let's H2. Let it be H2. And on that H2, let's create a class, and that class, let's call the class logo, okay? Class, call it. This is how far we can go for now. If the time goes on, we'll create more, but for now, let's work with it. Now, let's control S for save and see if it's gonna work. Let's for save. Let's open it. Let's open it and see if we're working. Remember, I'll put your lifesaver, if it's gonna work. It work. Okay, let's put something our H2. The H2, let us put our logo, and I don't write use the right top as logo. So let me just see EI and BEN with my Steven. Okay, and compress for save. That's up here. That means it's working. So let's move straight to our CSS. Type the CSS. Let's type some of the things. So first of all, if you notice very well, there is a padding. I always say about default padding. I don't want any default padding. I will remove the padding for all my body. So to do that, I will use asterisk or star. Okay. So I will use star. and open my code browser. Yeah, we want to do two things, okay? I want to make sure that the padding and the margin is zero. So put the padding and the margin to be zero, okay? So just give him padding zero, margin zero. Padding zero. And margin, let's make it zero as well. So padding should be zero, margin should be zero. So let's go to our main. Let's start with dot main. Dot main should be the first one. Remember our first div, the first class we created is div dot main. So on this dot main, I want to do some things. I want to give him a width. Let me start by giving him a width, okay? Let me give him a width. Oh, sorry, we need to bring it down first. Bring it down first. Let's give him a width. The width I want to give should be, how many percent do you want us to give it? Let's make it 100%. Let's make it 100%. The width should be 100%, okay? Width of 100%. And from the width, let me give him a background color. Not background color, but background image. And that background image, I want to actually do something. The background image should be, let's use linear gradient. Linear gradient. And the linear gradient, I want to use, let's go to top. Let it be to top. Linear gradient should be to top, okay? Top. And in that to top, let me use our RGBA. Let's use that RGBA. You know your RGB, so I don't want to explain anything because I believe we've learned all this. Well, in case you've forgotten anything, just go back to our class and try to get ideas of what we've learned before now, okay? So the RGB, let me start with zero. First one should be zero, comma zero, comma zero, comma 0.5. 0.5. Okay. Put a comma here. Give a space. Just copy this and repeat it. Okay. But meanwhile, I want this to take 50%. This is what I just did now. I want it to take 50%. Okay. So let me put it before the comma. Cover 50% of our write-up. 50% of the image. 50%. Then before the comma. Then let's just copy this. I want to paste it twice. Copy and paste twice. Copy and paste twice. So it will appear in two places. Okay. It should appear in two places. Let me make this one bold so I won't make mistake. And I see I've selected so many things. This is the reason I want to copy. See if you copy. So put comma, let's paste it again. Entry B, she appeared twice. Yes, this is exactly what I wanted. And now that that is done, let's move out of this bracket, give a space, and they're going to do our URL again. So now let's do a URL. You know your URL, so it's not new to you. URL. I have an image. If you don't have your image, make sure you get an image. If you don't have to do it, take our assessors on how to get image. I explained that there, okay? So C1. I would like to use C1. Image. C1.jpg. Okay? Have the image ready? That's all. So now that we've done, now that that is done, let's go to position. I want this to be background position. Let's create background position. I want it to be center. Okay. Background position should be center. So bring it down. Let's go to background size. Go to background size. Background size. And I want to use cover. You can use cover contain many things, okay? But I want to use cover. So after that, let me give him a height. Let's give our work a height, okay? at the heights. Let me see how many heights I'm going to give him right away. So let's give him a height. Let's give him a height. And I want the height to be 100 VH. 100 VH. So we're through with that. Let's go to the next one. And that next one should be less decorate our nav. So it should be dot nav. Okay, let's go to nav. Nav. Open your code browser. Bring it back. We're working on our nav. So under nav, let's start with width, okay? Let's give me a width. And the width, I think the width I would like to give my nav should be 1,200 pieces. Okay. Of that width, let's give him a height. The height I want to give my height to be 75 pieces. So let me give me a margin auto. Margin auto. Okay. I think that should be enough. That should be enough for our logo. Let's go to the next one. That should be enough for. So let's go to the next one, icon. Let's go to dot icon. Let's see how I'm gonna do to our icon. Okay. So next one should be dot icon. Dot icon, IOCN. Open your code browser. Bring it down. So for icon, let's start with color. Let's start with color. Color, let's give him, I think blue violet should be okay. Let's give him blue violet, okay? Blue violet. And from there, let's go to font size. Let's give me a font size. Let's give me a font size. And the font size I would like you should be 35 pieces. Five pieces. So from there, let's go to font family. Let's give the font a font family. Font family. The font family should be Arial, Helvetical, and Sans Serif. That should be okay. Arial, Helvetical, and Sans Serif. But you can delete anyone if you don't want all of them. Okay. So from font family, I want this to float left. Okay. I want this to float left. To float left. And then lastly, padding top. I want to give me a padding top. Padding top. Let me make it 10 pieces. Padding top. 10 pieces. There's a need to continue what I'm doing. Okay, padding top should be 10 pieces. I think it's okay like that. Should I give him padding left? I think it's good for me to give him padding left and padding top, okay? Let's still give it a padding left. Not be just padding top. Let me also put padding left, okay? So padding left, and I made that 20 pieces. Padding left should be 20 pieces. padding left should be 20 pieces, okay? Left. There should be 20 pieces. Okay. Twenty pieces. Okay. And let's go ahead. That's good. Let's check our work and see if everything we've done is okay. You just have to be okay. You just have to fly. For us to do that, make sure that you open your lifesavers. Can use that to check that. So let's try and run it and see if this is going to fly. Of course, save your work. Yeah, you can see it. It's only what we want. So let's continue. Let's continue. So come over to here. Let's go back to and create another div in between here. Sure, they should be in between here. Let's create more div that's going to work for us. So we just need to create another div. Let's create another div. Bring it down. Here's the div. And this div we want to create should be menu. Should be. So bring it down. Then in between the two div, we want to create another one that I will call should I call it div.menu? I've used div.menu, I don't want to use div.menu anymore. So div.menu, I call it. Yeah, what we used before is div.main. Okay. So call it div.menu. Okay. So it should be. Let's create a div with a class of menu. Class of menu. Class of menu. Okay. We bring it down. Then in between the two, we create an ordered list. We'll create an ordered list. Okay. UR. Create an ordered list. Bring it down. And the first list we want to create, which is the early one, should be Okay. Let's name this our home page. Have a home page. Have a home page. I want to create something that will lead us to lead us anywhere, but at least there's be a site that is not somewhere. So let me use a link. Okay. Anchor tag. Let me use anchor tag. I think anchor tag will be the best. Let me use anchor tag so that it actually lead us somewhere. Window is nowhere. So let's use our anchor tag. Okay, let me put it here. Let's type our A, which is our anchor tag. Then just copy this and paste it like 3 or 4 places. Copy and paste like 3 or 4 places. Control C for copy. I'm gonna paste like 3 or 4 places. Okay. Then here. Oh, sorry. Hush. Second, let's just keep putting the hash. I'm supposed to have paste it once and for all. Just copy this to save for copy. And now you cannot paste it in 3 or 4 places. Paste in 3 or 4 places. Paste in 3 or 4 places. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, confirm is okay. So here the first one should be our home. First one should be our home. Then from there let's move on to the next one. So we have our home. The next one should be virus. Virus. The next one. The services. you can put our services you like. And lastly, the last one to the contact, or you make it contact us if you like. Okay, contact. So let's do controls for save and see if this will fly. Okay. Yeah, it has appeared. Look at it right here. So we can now proceed to our spider CSS and then do justice to this, just the way we did to others as well. So let's continue our work. Let's proceed to style.css. All right, then style.css. Let's start with .menu, okay, which is the first one. It's gonna be .menu, okay. .menu. Open your code browser. Open your code browser. And under .menu, bring it down. Let's give him a width. Let's start with a width. Let's give me a width of giving a width of 400 pixels. Width of 400 pixels. Then we also give him let's float it left. Float left. Let it float left. Sorry. Bring it down. It float. Wanna float it left. So wanna be float left. Bring it down. Let's give me a height of 70 pieces. Height of 70 pieces. Okay. Height of 70 pieces. And that'll be okay. Let's go to our UL.ul. So let's also give him same thing. Let's give him a flow. It should also float left. Okay, float left. Float left. So float left. Float left. Left, okay. Very funny what happened right there with the lever. So let's go down, let's come down. Display should display flash, okay. I think we've done flash balls. If you miss class on flash balls, please kindly go back to our flash and see what you can learn from there. Refresh your memory and come back here. But no display flash. Display flash. And want to justify content. I go to justify content. Let me justify content. Let's make it center. Okay, let's make it center. And align item. Let's align it to center. Let's align it to center. Align item will also be center. Okay. Let's save our work. Let's see what. Let's see if everything is working fine. Yes, this is it. It's progressing. We're moving there. Actually, made some mistake. That's why it didn't work. Under this issue, it's not a class, it's just ordinary. So I moved the duct, okay, just supposed to be UL and not a class. So control S for save. Yeah, it works. You see it? See it. So let's continue. Let's go to our CS property. Let's go to designer CS property.